In the nursery trade, there is a distinction made between potted stock, container-grown stock, and containerized stock. Potted stock refers to seedlings, rooted cuttings, or recently grafted plants that are grown for a period of time in small pots before they are planted in large containers or lying out in the field. Container-grown stock is grown in the container from a seedling, rooted cutting, or graft to a saleable size in a relatively small volume of growth medium. Containerized stock is a field-grown plant that is dug and put in a container to be sold. I'm Dr. DeBosca, and this video will cover the requirements for container production. Many woody species of plants are successfully grown in nurseries in containers, and possibly in the future, nearly all woody plants will be container-grown. Today, it is estimated that 80 to 90% of the woody ornamentals produced in warmer states like California, Florida, and Texas are grown in containers, and this trend is expanding. Container culture is preferred over field culture for plants with wide-ranging roots. Cotton ester, pyracantha, spreading and low-growing juniper, etc., that are difficult to dig and plant successfully. A grower might decide to grow certain plants in container culture that require extensive soil modification, winter protection, or a quick turnaround so they can be produced to saleable size in a minimum length of time. Generally, any shallow-rooted plant, whether deciduous or evergreen, is best grown in a container. The primary objective of a production schedule for container-grown plants is to efficiently grow high-quality plants for the most profit. Because container-grown plants represent a greater capital investment than field-grown plants, it becomes essential to reduce costs by producing the plant in as short a time period as possible. Container production research has shown that larger containers promote greater rates of plant growth. Larger containers will require less frequent irrigation and fertilization once the plants are established, but will require more nursery production space. The additional cost of the space requires needs to be balanced against the additional rate of growth and the savings in transplanting. Most types of nursery stock in 1 gallon containers are grown for a period of 1 year or less, although some slow-growing plants will require 2 years to reach a marketable size. A few slow-growing dwarf types may be grown for 3 or 4 years. The rule for proper spacing of container-grown plants is that the leaf tips of adjacent plants should be touching. This spacing procedure results in compact growth of good quality as well as an efficient use of production space. Spacing too closely results in spindly growth and loss of the lower foliage. Applying the spacing rules, most transplants can be placed pot tight or rim to rim for the first few months and possibly first year of growth. A crop succession plan with the space requirements drawn to scale should be worked out in advance of planning so that costly errors will not be made and plants need not be moved great distances. Site preparation should include provisions for adequate drainage, an efficient layout, freedom from weeds, year-round use, and a base soil that will support traffic. A good site for growing nursery crops in containers should be well drained in order to carry off large amounts of water in a short time during rainstorms or from overhead irrigation. Careful site planning can reduce costs. It should include an efficient layout of growing areas and roadways for efficient use of machinery. The base or growing surface should be relatively inexpensive to install and maintain. The site should be free from weeds and should permit working year-round. Most commonly used include black plastic, fiber weed barrier, crushed stone, or asphalt. Nursery stock can be planted in 1 to 5 gallon containers by potting machines using rooted cuttings, 1-year-old seedlings, dormant unrooted cuttings, dormant grafts, or plants previously grown in smaller pots. The plants should be placed in the center of the container at the depth at which they originally grew, usually the root collar, and the growing medium firmly placed around the roots to ensure good contact with the roots. The container is filled within 1/2 inch to 1 inch, depending on pot size, of the rim to leave a space for water accumulation during irrigation. Most nurseries, small or large, devise an assembly line system with machines and labor so the planting operation can be done efficiently. Usually there are separate crews or individuals responsible for supplying plants in pots, filling pots, placing plants in pots, loading the planted containers, and moving them to the growing area where they are set in place. A crew of 5 workers is usually able to plant, place, and hand water at a rate of 7,000 to 12,000 per day. The same crew can do up to 20,000 per day with a semi-automatic potting machine once they become familiar with the procedure. Pruning and shearing goals are the same for plants and container and field-grown crops. Because of the faster growth rate, all types of plants should be sheared and formed more frequently in container culture. It is normally necessary to cut back leaders 3 or 4 times each growing season. If prostrate forms are not spaced adequately and pruned regularly, they will have a tendency to grow with a more upright habit, which reduces their marketability. There are several objectives of pruning container-grown nursery stock. The first is to get as large a plant as possible, as quickly as possible, and at the same time, obtain a healthy plant with a form or shape that will be marketable. Usually this means a plant that is dense, compact, symmetrical, healthy, and vigorous, and that can be sold at a profit. Another important objective of pruning is to produce a plant that transplants successfully, whether planted by a landscape contractor or homeowner. A good balance between root and shoot growth in container culture is vital to the successful establishment of a plant when it is planted in the landscape. Pruning at times is both a dwarfing and an invigorating cultural practice, depending on how and when the heading back or thinning out pruning is done. Usually a large plant can be produced faster with minimum pruning, as severe pruning produces a smaller but dense plant. The grower should use a combination system of pruning, which includes both heading back terminals and thinning out branches. This consists of heading back to increase density of thin plants, thinning areas of an otherwise dense plant, and thinning of dense growth to produce a plant that is taller and wider. Thinning may be used to increase size of flowers and fruit by reducing the number of flowering branches after buds have developed. There should be no indiscriminate shearing. Effective pruning of nursery plants begins with selection of the cuttings or seedlings, as well as pruning practice early in the life of the plants. A compact container-grown plant can be produced more easily from 4 to 6 inch cuttings than from 2 to 3 inch cuttings. Smaller cuttings sometimes root faster but take longer to produce plants to the size where heading back is done to increase density of the potted plants. However, a 4 to 6 inch cutting usually has enough leaves to produce good rooting, and because of this, will reach the stage sooner at which pruning is begun. Container grown nursery stock is ready to be sold when it has reached an appropriate size for the container. If plants are held too long in the same container, growth will be reduced and the root system will become pot bound, will have developed into a heavy, tight spiral around the inside wall and bottom of the container. Several plant production systems have been developed by growers and researchers to combat these problems. There are all variations of the same idea, but some are on the ground and some are in the ground. The Minnesota in-ground container production system was developed in 1981. The system was designed for tree production and has some unique features. A sturdy plastic container is buried in the ground to its top. Drainage holes 2 inches from the bottom create a water reservoir in the container that serves to prune the roots by restricting oxygen. The environmentally friendly containers have been used both in-ground and above-ground, as well as the pot-in-pot concept to increase the water reservoir and reduce heat stress. The pot-in-pot technique involves sinking a permanent container into the ground and then placing another container, which holds the tree, inside the buried one. The double container system provides insulation from temperature extremes, prevents blowing over, and simplifies harvesting. Some southern nurseries are using an accelerator system that uses a cylinder of perforated corrugated aluminum placed on a woven plastic mat. The corrugated aluminum is overlapped to form a cylinder and is held together with sheet metal screws. The container diameter can be increased by removing 2 sheet metal screws, reducing the overlap, and reinserting the screws. Potting media is then added inside the larger container and the repotting operation is completed. This is particularly efficient in the production of larger, fast-growing trees. The outer aluminum cylinder is removed and the root ball is burlapped and shrink-wrapped for shipping, and the cylinders are reused. This system substantially reduces the cost of repotting and produces excellent growth. Considerable effort by nursery operations is given to plant production, as previously mentioned, and to the post-harvest storage and shipping practices to provide the best possible care for nursery stock. Insufficient care in the garden center or improper planting in the landscape often negates this special handling. Growers should inform retailers and customers about proper care and landscape management practices. Many growers are using care tags on every plant offered for sale. Cooperative Extension Service bulletins are available to retailers to provide their customers with instructions on planting, watering, fertilizing, pruning, and pest control. This service costs little, and the potential benefits are great for our industry. In conclusion, in this video, hopefully you learned about what it takes to grow container plants in the nursery business.